Hello YouTube, welcome to yet another new video. So today we've got quite a few new 2022 reveals to go over from Singles Case H. So let's get right into it. Seven cards are revealed today. I'm going to break them down and discuss them and share my thoughts on them. So first off, I'll start with the two that I don't have any photos for. So first off, we've got Keith Cohn, also known as the Camera Hog fan. I don't have him in person. Same with the second one I'm gonna discuss. So the name's a bit odd. It sounds more like a fan made name than an actual Mattel name, but it's not the worst name ever. I've heard much worse before. Not really much to say about him, but it's cool. Quite cool. It's a new Cars 1 release and new Cars 1 race fan, so I personally can't really say I'm complaining. It's good that we've got a few new Cars 1 releases over the past few months, so such as Keith Cohn, Sarah Wilson, Derek Williams, none other that come to mind right now, but if there are, then I'll. But if I can think of any more, then I will mention them. Second, we have got Race Damaged King. Damaged the King, as his official name is. And this is a release people have been waiting for years. His only release was in 2009, the Race Arama series, and he has skyrocketed in value since then. So I can understand why people would buy him for a high price, angry to see him back, but I personally do think he is quite a good re-release. And I'll put a photo up on the screen, but he is actually smiling this time, so his expression has changed officially. So those who bought the China variant for a high price and opened it, there's still some value in those, I suppose. But yeah. Next up, we have Cruz Ramirez as Francis Beltline with Barrel. So officially, I wouldn't count it's a new release because even the Barrel has been released before. There's quite a silly, gimmicky release like the Light McQueen with Piston Cup from last year. At least the Piston Cup is a cool accessory that's quite useful. I don't think anyone really cares about the Thunder Hollow Barrel, which can't say this is one I have much interest in getting. I will get one to keep carded, definitely, but I'm not sure yet if I'll get one to open for the Barrel. I'll cross a bridge when I get to it. Next up is Mel Dorado, and I am happy to see him back after so long. However, Thailand has completely botched his colour. As you can see, it looks horrible now. I can already tell that when I do end up doing a country comparisons episode, China Mel will be the one I prefer because of how cheap and nasty Thailand Mel is, even though it is cool to see him back because he's been released twice, single in 2012 in the Poro Corsa Cars 2 mainline, and in 2014 in the Mel Dorado Show series. Speaking of the Mel Dorado Show series, we finally have our answer as to who Beaker is. And it is Lee Race. So it just boggles my mind because he was released. He was released as a Chase. Officially, Chases can't be re-released. Yeah, they've gone and released Lee Race. Which I suppose really just comes to show they're prioritising money over all else. They just want to get some releases out of make a bit more money, I guess. I don't really know how to describe it, but he's certainly one of the better probably one of the best re-releases this year, actually, but I still find it quite disappointing that they're re-releasing him regardless, because it goes against the entire concept of what a chase is. Officially, the only chase that's been re-released for now is Guido with Paint Rollers. However, they re-released him under a different name, so that's how you could try and excuse that. But Nate Stanchion and Jessica Giampetro have been going to come with a two-pack this year, so I guess it does make sense that they're re-releasing all three this year, but I don't get why they re-release a chase. That mean they're going to be re-releasing more chases in the future. I hope not, but we shall see. So next up is Finish Line Lightning McQueen, and there's not much I can say about him really. He's supposedly he does not have the mouth plate like the China or Vietnam variants do, which is good. No, not a massive fan of the mouth plates. Like there's worse. There's worse things in the world, but sort of doesn't mean I really like them, to be honest. But first time he's been released as a normal single, actually. He's been released as a, by himself once. That was in the Lightning McQueen box in 2017. And his artwork isn't the worst, actually. It's like a rotated version of Tongue Lightning McQueen's artwork, which I suppose looks a bit odd, but it works. When I saw this, I actually thought it was Tongue Lightning McQueen at first, but no. At least they gave him the right name this time, though, because in the 11-pack he was released in last year, they just called him Tongue Lightning McQueen. So, not my absolute favourite release from this year, but still quite good to see him back, in my opinion. More classic releases of this year. Next up is Brad Windmiller. It's actually the last one we'll be covering. So I do find it frustrating that he's back. Although it does make sense because we got Darla Fanderson, Timmy Fee, Two Stroke, and Matthew True Blue McCrew, as well as Keith Cohn. So it makes sense to bring back Brad. However, Both his releases, full stop, 2016 and 2017, were massive peg warmers. And Darla, Timothy, and Matthew have all. Darla and Matthew, especially, have pegged warms. Timothy, Two Stroke as well, but to a slightly lesser extent. So I do hope this means that the same does not happen to Brad, but I wouldn't be surprised if it does. Once again, considering a lot of the re-releases this year, just from 2019 and 21, it's good to see some older ones back in the mix. And Brad Windmiller, I'm not like, super excited about him, but he's probably one of this year's better releases. But anyway, that is indeed it for the video, so there's nothing else I have to say. So please like, subscribe, comment, favourite, share, so on and so forth. And as always, I will see each and every one of you in the very next video.